Good morning, students. We will continue with the CSS. In a previous lecture, we discussed what is CSS. CSS is a designing feature that provides designing to the HTML web pages. The benefit of CSS is fast formatting and changes. So it is a centralized processing. Now, CSS, cascading style sheet. So cascading style sheets are of three different types. Number one, it is internal. Second one is, it is external. Number three, it is inline. So there are three type of CSS: internal, external, and inline. In the case of internal CSS, it is applicable on the same web page on which you want to provide changes. External is a external file. When we will import that file, the that particular features will be applicable. Inline is a applicable on a particular tag. Okay, so Raghav, any doubt in this?
No, sir.
Okay, beta. Now, in the case of inline CSS, we use style tag, then type is a attribute and value is text slash CSS. This is the common feature. And remember one thing, style tag we will include in head tag, not in body tag. Then we use the tag name on which we want to apply the changes. Here is H1 is a tag. We can take here, we can take here comma, we can take here H2 like this. Okay. And after that, curly bracket start, then curly bracket close. Inside this, different commands are there. And these two commands we will discuss in these classes. Okay, beta. So ye humne command discuss karni hai, kaun si commands hai, uski categories kaun si hai, and then their possible value. Everything we will discuss. Then curly bracket close. And remember one thing, all different commands will be separated with the help of semicolon. So this is the important thing. Then after that, if we want to give another type of formatting, then again, tag start, curly bracket close, and then like this, and at the end, you will close style. So if we will discuss the structure or structures, we will use style, then type text slash CSS, and after that you will use here tag name on which you want to apply the changes. So look at here, suppose you want to apply this. On H1 and curly bracket start, curly bracket close, and different commands. Okay, different commands, semicolon, another command, semicolon, and like this. But at the end, last command, you can skip semicolon. And after that, take another tag. If your formatting is different, if formatting is common, you can use here H1, H2. But if formatting is different, for example, font tag, curly bracket start, command, command, number of any number of commands. Then curly bracket close, and you can take number of styles, and at the end use close style tag. This is the way. So in last lecture I have already discussed, there is a inline lookup here, and when we apply this H1, if we use H1 number of times, same feature will be applicable. So now we will discuss external CSS. If I am not using the designing inside the HTML file, in that case the benefit of in your external CSS is, external CSS can be used in multiple pages, web pages, but internal CSS can be used only this is for a single web page. It means a web page in which you declare style tag will be applicable. It is not a global, but whenever you will declare CSS as external CSS, you can use it in number of web pages. So now I am going to discuss external CSS, how we can declare external CSS. So number one thing, for using external CSS, we will have to create a new file. So in this file, we will include only the designing. Look at here, only this one, only styles, nothing else. Suppose one in H1 and H2, we want color bold, font, family, Vardhana, font size 100 pixels, and on a font tag, I want to apply color yellow. So this is my formatting. I'm going to save this file. Look at here in desktop. I will save this file with the, suppose my file dot CSS. तो आपने क्या करना है, जितनी styles हैं आपने file में declare कर देने हैं, and then you will have to click on save button. It means this is my designing file. If I open this file in browser, nothing will be happened because this is only a designing file. Now I am going to create a HTML file. So look at here, HTML head tag, title, first page, title close, head close, then body tag start, and in H1 I type CBSE class 10th, and H1 close. Class 10th students, listen one thing, your term wise curriculum has been issued by CBSE. Okay, so I will share later on, I will share the link of term wise syllabus. So CBSE has introduced this term wise syllabus of your class 9 to +2. So aapka term wise syllabus CBSE ne introduce kar diya hua hai. So after that, here I use font tag, Thomson Das Public School, and then I use I close the tag, font tag, then body tag, then HTML tag. So I close these tags. Now, how we can import this file, the design file, myfile.css in HTML. So look at here, inside head tag, you will use link type equal to CSS text slash CSS REL. It is an attribute. It is a style sheet. And important one is href. href means here we will have to give reference name of the file with the designing file with which you want to apply take the designing. So look at here, my file name is myfile.css, myfile.css. I will close this tab. Now I am going to save this in desktop. I save this with my web page dot html. I save this. Now look at here, I open the web page in browser. So look at here, I have not set the designing in HTML web page, but due to the CSS file, the designing is automatically applicable. Look at here. So if you have any doubt, raise your hands. I am showing you the coding. This is my web page. Raghav, yes,
sir, इसके अंदर HTML की फाइल के एक्सटेंशन में क्या लिखते हैं डॉट
इन HTML?
यस सर, जब CSS की फाइल अटैच कर दी तो
लुक एट हियर, आई एम शोइंग द कोडिंग विद अस, लुक एट हियर. इट इज हियर लिंक टैग, इट इज एन एम्प्टी टैग. Then its attribute is type equal to text slash CSS. Then REL attribute equal to style sheet, because we are using style sheet. href equal to myfile.css. Raghav.
Sir, I was asking about file name. File name mein end mein kya likhte hain? .html.
You are telling about the HTML file, or okay, beta, here is a error in whether it is a, it should be HTML or HTM. Okay, beta.
Sir, आपने CHTML लिखा हुआ
है. बेटा इसमें क्योंकि यहाँ पे error हुई, error के कारण file open नहीं हो रही थी, but I opened the file in browser, that's why the output is there. Okay. Raghav, clear beta? Raghav? Okay, beta. So this is your external CSS. So external CSS is a global CSS. If I have in my website, I have 1000 web pages, and in 1000 web pages, I have imported the external CSS, the design will be applicable. But in the case of your inline CSS, it is applicable on a single web page, but on multiple tags. अगर मेरे पास मैंने यहाँ पे जो इंटरनल सीएसएस बनाई थी ये इसमें अगर मैं मल्टीपल टाइम आई एम यूजिंग H1 टैग द सेम कोडिंग विल बी एप्लीकेबल नाउ इट मींस द एरिया इज अ लार्ज एप्लीकेबल एरिया इन द केस ऑफ एक्सटर्नल सीएसएस बट इन द केस ऑफ इंटरनल सीएसएस इट इज नैरो बट व्हेन वी यूज इनलाइन इट इज एप्लीकेबल ओनली ऑन ए सिंगल tag. Okay, so look at here, I'm taking here inline, CSS, I'm saving this. Okay students, so you will not apply any type of formatting in header tag. Okay, in place of that, in H1 tag, so on the select the tag on which you want to apply the changes, in that particular tag you will declare, you will use one attribute style. So you will use style tag attribute, and after that you will use double quotes and these commands like color blue semicolon font size 100 pixels and then you will close this tag. So other tag I am closing, removing this coding here from here. So I am saving this. So look at here, design is applied, designs are applied, but here is inline. It means the tag on which you want to apply the changes. So this is your inline. Okay students, any doubt here? Yes, Vite. And Shika.
Yes, sir. सर कल नैन्सी मैम ने ये स्टाइल एट्रीब्यूट बॉडी टैग में करवाया था तो ये कहीं भी लग जाएगा
बेटा व्हेनेवर यू हियर स्टाइल इज एन एट्रीब्यूट इट इज इनलाइन बट व्हेनेवर यू यूज स्टाइल टैग अंडर हेड टैग इट इज इंटरनल सीएसएस
यस सर कल नैन्सी मैम ने इनलाइन में स्टाइल टैग स्टाइल एट्रीब्यूट जो है वो बॉडी टैग में करवाया था
हाँ यू कैन बेटा दिस इज एन एट्रीब्यूट यू कैन यूज इट इन बॉडी टैग यू कैन यूज इट इन फॉन्ट टैग यू कैन यूज इट इन H1 टैग इन एनी टैग यू कैन यूज दिस ओके दिस इज एन एट्रीब्यूट
ओके
ओके
ओके थैंक यू
ओके बेटा सो दिस टैग इज हियर व्हेन यू यूज इनलाइन सीएसएस स्टाइल इज ए टैग अंडर हेड टैग बट व्हेनेवर यू आर यूजिंग इनलाइन style is an attribute you can use it in any type of tag yes any doubt here yes Bhumika
yes sir jo style attribute hai wo head tag ke andar bhi use ho sakta hai
beta in case agar humne style tag head tag mein use kar liya wo internal css ban jayegi ठीक है I'm just giving one example don't confuse with this I'm just giving one example look at here ओके स्टूडेंट्स, इन केस आई एम यूजिंग ए सीएसएस, एक्सटर्नल सीएसएस, आई एम यूजिंग वर्ड एक्सटर्नल सीएसएस. In that case, if I have multiple web pages, I can import this CSS in any web page. This is your external CSS. But when I am using internal CSS, so I have one internal CSS. It is here, I am using here internal CSS. This is applicable on a single web page. So this is a web page. And I can apply this on different tags. Suppose here is a one tag, H1 tag, one tag. Then I have another tag, H1. I have third tag H1. H1 means you can take any tag here. So on all of these tags, internal CSS automatically applied. But when you use inline CSS, so this is my web page. I have one tag. Single web page. And I have one tag that is H1. Now remember one thing. Internal CSS, inline CSS will be applicable only on a single tag. Here is style. Look at here. This is internal CSS. So multiple tags, we must have multiple CSS. Look at here, this is inline CSS. So students, any doubt in this? Yashit?
No, sir.
Okay, beta. So now, next is, so remember one thing, in the case of your external CSS can be imported only with the help of this coding, link tag. It is an empty tag and used inside head tag. So remember this coding. Now next is, first there are different way for applying the CSS, internal, external, and inline. There are classes are there, different things are there. But before their discussion, I want to discuss different CSS commands. This is important. Look at here. Different CSS commands. तो फर्स्ट इज कलर एंड बैकग्राउंड. सो दिस CSS, we will the different commands for colors and backgrounds. So the different CSS are color, background, color, then background, image and background. These are the different commands or properties. The good name is properties. So now we are going to discuss these properties. Okay, beta. The I am using here in CSS. You use here the H1. H2, this is called selector. इसे हम क्या कहते हैं बेटा, selector. तो आपने क्या करना है, जो भी आपने selector लेना है, जिसके ऊपर apply करना है आपने, ठीक है? Suppose I want to use it, suppose in H1, I'm using it, taking here H1, ठीक है? I'm taking here color, कोई भी आपने जो color apply करना है. तो सबसे पहली प्रॉपर्टी जो आपके पास करने हम जा रहे हैं, दैट इज कॉल्ड कलर. सो कलर प्रॉपर्टी यूज टू सेट द फॉन्ट कलर, फॉन्ट कलर, ठीक है? तो आपने क्या करना है, जो भी आपने सिलेक्टर लेना है, पहले सिलेक्टर लेना है, सिलेक्टर एंड इन कर्ली ब्रैकेट आई एम टेकिंग हियर कलर कॉलन. इन सीएसएस प्रॉपर्टीज इक्वल टू साइन नहीं यूज होता. So you will have to take here value of color. Value of color may be your color name or color code. These are the two important things. Okay. So look at here. In the case of your CSS file, I am taking here color blue. So you can take here any color name. Or you can here take any color code like hash here. I'm taking here FFCC66. It is the same hexadecimal number system number. And I have already discussed this in during the HTML discussion. So I am saving this. I'm applying this. This is a different web page. Wait. So look at here, different color here. So this is called color property. Next is, if I want to set any background color, the property is background, then --color. And then you will take any color name or color code. Okay. So look at here. In my CSS, in my external CSS, I am declaring here the background. Here, look at here. If I am using in H1, it means it will change the background of H1. If I am using it in body tag, it will change the background color of complete body. So look at here. Background colon a background color green. I am saving this. Look at here. If I will use it in body tag, it will change the complete background color of the वेब पेज। केशव इट इज क्लियर बेटा? यस भूमिका, ओके ओके। नाउ नेक्स्ट इज इन केस यू वांट टू सेट एनी बैकग्राउंड इमेज, ओके। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू, दिस इज इक्विवेलेंट टू द बैकग्राउंड इमेज, जो आपने कोई भी बैकग्राउंड में कोई पिक्चर लगानी है, आपने यू वांट टू सेट, उसमें आपके पास बीजी कलर होता है कलर सेट करने के लिए और बैकग्राउंड होता है इमेज सेट करने के लिए, इन द सेम वे। सो आई एम टेकिंग हियर बैकग्राउंड देन इमेज, सो यू विल सेट हियर, यू विल टेक हियर यूआरएल इन डबल कोट्स, यू विल टेक the name of with extension any image file. So I'm taking here one image, look at here, copy the name of the file with extension. So you will set here we'll use the coding background image colon URL in bracket braces in double quotes, use the name of the file with extension. I'm saving this. So look at here. Because we have used in H1, so in H1 this image has been set. In case we will use body tags, look at here. I am using here body tag. So look at here. Next is when we set any background as an image, there are some more properties we can use. If your image size is very small, when you will set the image, that will naturally you will get a blur image. In that case, you can use one attribute that is called background repeat. Whether you want to repeat in x-axis means aapki ho jayegi horizontally repeat hogi, y-axis vertical repeat means all the direction, no repeat, there will be no repetition. But remember one thing, if image size is, your image size is very small, otherwise look at here, I'm saving this, okay. Agar aapka image size bahut small hai, look at here, I'm searching बेटा। नेक्स्ट वीक वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द सीएसएस,